Hello, welcome back to Let's Play, or rather, Let's Build the 200 Subscribers Special. So today is going to be a shorter episode, just focused on basically air defense for the carrier battle group. So I'm going to start by... we need a new task pool, first of all. Alright, so... let's start with, the Enterprise Fighter Wing. So we will, and then based off of that, if I remember correctly, it is a package that we have to make. AAW Patrol. Currently inactive. Actually, you know what? Let's set that to active. There we go. There we go. Alright, the reference points. Let's see. So I will just define an area, probably, okay. Do I just make, all right, that's fair enough. I'm just going to drag some of these points around. Oh. There we go, and we'll select them all. So now this should work. There we go. Actually, let me rename Zone 1. So, in our fighter wing, we should have... we basically just want these guys in our task. Actually, you know what? We don't even want all of them. Let's take, we just want the ones currently slated for air superiority in our task pool. Right. Which, it's not as clean the way those were divvied out, but it is what it is, right? Air superiority. All right, there we go. So there's our task pool. And now we can define the mission for this. We should have immediate takeoff time because, there, we can set the home base because they should always be running this. Let's see here. Mission settings, 1/3 rule. So we have 34 units. So let's try to keep 10 on station. We'll have active missions only movement, random within area. Flight size 2. Just one, we just need one flight to trigger the mission. Just one flight to engage. All flights engage hostile contacts. Um, Okay, that doesn't really do much for us. Yeah, they'll go to high loiter cruise flight plan. I'll leave this to, well, you know what? I'll experiment and put this to one flight. Just because I don't know if, what does this do? Oh, tankers, okay. I don't know if that's going to sit like one flight per contact, or if it's all flights, or if it's the number of flights that are allowed to engage any and all contacts. Because we saw a lot with the when we tested the Chinese side of this, the fighters were basically just dogpiling onto like a single contact and wasting all their missiles, which I want to reflect better coordination. So I don't want more than like one flight engaging a contact. So that's my reasoning for that right now. EM comm and weapons engagements. Yeah, they will be Surge Temple with quick turnaround. And I think most of these are, yeah, crank and drag. We won't, Peter hiccup there for a second. Yeah, most of this isn't really applicable to what we're doing. I'm just reading over it. I think most of it is fine. The only. Okay, they have no priority. So I think this is what we're going to do. And I'm going to just save the game now. And then we're going to quick edit sides, posture, unfriendly. All right. So now I just want to run a test now and so this should be active. Actually, probably the operation planner, right? Here, counter air one will say triggered. E2 support north, south triggered. And that should be enough to get things going. So I'm going to crank up the speed now. And let's look at. Aircraft, we see two are currently working towards launch. The catapults are all busy, so I'm not surprised that these others are idle yet. And it might need tweaking on my part too, so. Oh, I hate. It's sometimes useful when it pauses automatically like that, but. Sometimes it, yep, there we go. We got F-35 going up. So I think it will cycle through these depending on what it wants to do, which ones it prioritizes. And this will also, if the carrier does get hit with less planes, you know, that are just sitting on the hangar, the flight deck, fueled up and armed up, that will make the carrier less vulnerable to damage during an attack too, which as we saw Took a lot of damage from just a couple of hits, whereas the Chinese carrier seemed to be more resistant. But there could have been other factors at play there too than just number of aircraft on deck. All right, so we have. So CI is up. I saw one of them transitioning. Let's see. Am I breaking it when I say triggered? I would think, yeah, mobilize assigned to unit 0. Activate. Oh, here, bulk action, activate. But no, I don't want to loot a Lua script. Do I have to put it to waiting for trigger? Oh, no, these are triggered in there. And it is activated. It's just not. Oh, let me check the times. I always assume. Okay, well, for one, the simulation's not running anymore. But let me check the times too, because I always assume that the time that I put in for activation time is now. But I think we saw that's not always the case. Two thirty-four. Yeah, so this is in the future. So that's why they aren't mobilizing yet, I think. So let's put it at 36. And see if that changes things. Should. Yeah, everything seems right. I guess I'll just wait a few minutes and see any changes. Oh, okay. We see another unit being tasked here. An elevator en route to the flight deck. Man. Okay. Just gotta let it ride for a little bit. These guys still being funky with their sensors. Oh, would you look at that? We're being jammed. Hello. And the counter volleys are away. Hey, look, we have our ERAMs out now. Okay, this is perfect. Still parked on the flight deck and not. Why won't you trigger? I know it's something I'm doing wrong, but oh, do I have to? Maybe I have to trigger like the task pool tool like that. Operation planner. We'll say you're triggered. Maybe that'll be enough. Also activate both of you. Make sure you're activated. Now let's try. Are you guys launching or? Okay, they're in the task pool, but they aren't being assigned the task for whatever reason. there. Start the mission! Alright, and you can see these have much longer range too, which is why I kind of want to use them sparingly. I'm glad they aren't launching a ton over here. Battle group itself should still have plenty. Yeah, 285. So even just doing that to narrow down the how many contacts we're getting. Oh, don't obey EMCOM. We're on that radar. Oh, the sub. I gotta fix the subs. Especially since they're trying to lock on to something and they aren't doing too good of a job. Alright, so now you can see they're opening up. I still wanna fix. Why is. Let's check the air tasking order. Okay, so there is no air tasking order that's been created. For some reason. Oh. I see my mistake now. And alright, looks like we got another moving another aircraft to the flight deck. Let's run it out, and I think. Oh, you know, I think it's because I have to click the dynamic checkbox, but. Alright, everyone's firing their long range anti ship missiles, which I generally. What do they think they're firing at? We don't have any. I think they're trying to attack the battle group, but it's being funky. I was gonna say now they should be in range of enhanced Sea Sparrow missiles. I do want to launch a manual attack, though. They need to break this group up a little bit. Okay. Even just, like, half of them. Whatever. Ba-ba. Anyone. There we go. That should do some work to thin them out. Up, oh, we got an AIM 260. Which means that we have aircraft airborne. Oh damn. they're getting into the fight right off. But I think we'll find that the carrier battle group definitely survives this volley better than last time. And I'll just quick sim it out, but we can see our aircraft are getting airborne now. And they will attack hostile contacts, including enemy missiles. Yeah, these guys just don't stand a chance now. And the best part is some of these should be able to be retasked. Yeah, I gotta change the engagement rules again, because I really do want them to hold their tomahawks and long-range anti-ship missiles in reserve until I actually give them the order to fire, but hope they got another group of vampires inbound. Okay, these guys are at the end of their fuel there, but they're still gonna hit it around Mach 1, it looks like, so... CI-4 should be here. Oh, LO, low observable. Okay. I was like, what does that mean? But, see what it means now. Or at least that's what I assume. Yeah, 35C. And it looks like once they're out of weapons, they are automatically breaking off to land at the carrier, which should automatically replenish. Yeah, you can see now 63 aircraft are just sitting idle now as opposed to the 97. Whew. All right, that's a lot of missileage, and that saves on as if you go to is it under weapons? Come on. Oh, I know why it's not doing that. If you go to nope, not weapons. Magazines. You'll see that the carrier magazine from which the aircraft reload from actually have all this stuff, which, for the most part, you'll notice we have much greater or significantly large reserves of missiles versus, you know, what can be stored in a destroyer magazine. So, that gives them... Yeah, you can see this attack is very thinned out now. And we're still maintaining effective top cover. Well, not quite, but... We got one flight. I think that this is working out well so far. They have only Sidewinders left. It's not great. But I suppose the... Yeah, you know what? Return the base. You have nothing left as well, so return the base. So they can get some new equipment. We should see Enterprise is down to 48 aircraft. So basically, you see these guys are all taking off or queuing for takeoff. This guy is completing landing. And what else we got here? Yeah, we're going to be launching Super Hornets to replenish. And I'm curious to see what the rearmament time and the refueling time is. They shouldn't need much time to refuel since these guys were barely up in the air, but they will definitely need rearmament time. Winchester. And some of them shouldn't even need full rearmament time since you can see some of them still have, they still have Sidewinders out. Alright, we got two missiles left. I think we're gonna manage to nab them. Alright, this guy should still hit it around a bit under Mach 1. Alright. Well, the cannon took care of it. So you can see there's a lot of oh no, that's not low observable. I wonder what that means. LS or L102345. I wonder if that's stuff for like landing pattern. This guy's probably like landing right now. Yeah, you can see as his sensor range drops to near zero. Oh, and the carrier just put a new one up. So, yeah, I think we got this working. So, oh, that's how I'm able to get the, does the satellite sees them. All right. So we'll see how this attack fares on the, I'm going to manually plot a course for our AWACS down there to keep an eye on things. But we'll see how our attack fares. We can see we have multiple flights up in the air now. And they are ready to dance. They even have drones. What's the Perdix actually do? Looks like recon mostly. Recon and decoy. Alright. Actually, what we're going to do now is switch sides here. And we'll just see how well the Chinese can fare against a smaller but similar and high-tech, more high-tech attack. Since, after all, they we do have some of the stealthier cruise missiles compared to what they're currently using. All right, now they just see generic cruise missile. Oh. These might be the long-range anti-ship missiles, which they're only... Yeah, because they can't get a good fix on them right now. Guided weapon, subsonic. We'll drop down to 5X. Okay, they're only getting a fix at about... maybe 8 miles. Not great. And you can see the very short range that they can see these at do not lend themselves to a lot of engagement. There we go. There's a hit. Let's pop up our message log and pop it out. Gotta love that old style log. So we can see the destroyer Nanning is sinking. They took 2 hits and now they're sinking. So now the at least the long-range anti-ship missile should have re-attack capability, so they'll be able to attack the other ships in the battle group. All right, so these are probably the Tomahawks now coming in. Looks like they're still going for that. They are going for the carrier. Boom, boom. Let's see. Let's check the logs here. You can see the onboard jammers are actually spoofing or jamming some of the... because most American cruise missiles do have an onboard suite of ECM. And you can see here the Tomahawks are actually jamming... some of their missiles, which is quite embarrassing. Weapon endgame. Weapon damage. All right, it looks like those Tomahawks might have been unit lost. Damage. Okay, it's not showing me much. Let's go into group composition. Yeah, it looks like they managed to shoot it down just shy of the supply ship there. Oh, we got a hit on the Ziyang. We got more long-range anti-ship missiles coming in that they aren't getting good discrimination on. Ooh, that was a close one for the destroyer there. Oh, the AOE is actually shot down another missile. Their 30 mils are doing some pretty good work there, basically intercepting for the of the Tao there. The Zanjing is sinking. And it looks like the last wave of missiles is coming in now. Obviously, again, this isn't how I plan on executing these attacks with the carrier battle group. And in fact, I thought I changed their weapons release authorization so that way they weren't using Tomahawks against surface ships, but oh well. But obviously, I plan on this being significantly more coordinated. So they've lost two destroyers and had a cruiser damage so far. And I expect that they should be able to handle these at the very least. Oh, I think these are more cruise missiles, but they're the derpy ones. Yeah, we can see the Hawkeyes, we can see the Super Hornets. Which, the reason I think the positioning on these is so good is just, one, it's not frontal aspect, which is what they're optimized for, is frontal aspect stealth. But also just because they should be actively emitting. So while they can't, looks like they don't have a good read on what's emitting, you know, like how we can tell that this is an APY-9, but they can see that they're emitting, so. Alright, we got one missile coming in. Yeah, I was gonna say, that one should be a easy one there. God, these guys are all... I probably will have to adjust their patrol routes, because the, and kind of break it up for the helicopters, too. Just because they're so ridiculous right now. It's like, just a clump of helicopters over on the east side. It's like, no, we need, like, one helicopter here, one helicopter here, one helicopter there. Or not even that, just have one helicopter here and one here probably would probably be sufficient. So that's definitely something I'm going to have to fix. Who the hell is firing? I wonder if that's our Hornets or something. If they decided to come out and play. But now you can see their, if they knock out all three, that's going to really hurt their ability to see these missiles coming in. And, oh, okay, that one survived. So maybe these aren't the derpy ones I thought, but rather fighters. And now they're drawing away missiles from the battle group that could be spent on, you know, actual cruise missiles and taking out their AWACS on top. All right, so we got another batch of missiles coming in. And these are short-range point defense missiles. So right now, they are not terribly effective. They will be a little more effective as they get closer. I think about within 10 miles is their optimum range, just based on how quickly they consume fuel. And there's the last helicopter. So we have another missile here. Coming in at Mach 4.5. Holy shit. Is this what I think it is? Okay, no, it's not. But, yeah, we did have... the fighters did come over here and decide to just fuck up their helicopters. That's kind of funny. I don't know what... Oh, because they launched the new helicopter. That's what he's going for there. But it's funny how they're basically just harassing the Chinese fleet at this point. It's really sad. Unknown air contact. Boo! You can see there's one more aircraft. Alright, looks like there's four reserve AWACS they have left. I think that's probably going to be all for this episode then. I'm happy I've identified a few more flaws. Yeah, okay, they're launching another strike. I'll massively speed it up until they get within range. But, I got air cover working for the U.S., so that's good. We still need to do some similar stuff for the Chinese side, and I think I might have made similar mistakes with some of those other missions. So that's definitely going to be something to look at. But at this point, they're severely weakened that they might be able to... I'm kind of surprised they haven't... Well, I know why they haven't knocked these guys out. It's because I haven't positively ID'd them yet. This Hawkeye might be about to, since it looks like he's about to overfly them. Engine hit, penetration, 92%. Jump to location. Oh, they're talking about the helicopter. All right, so our Hornets are continuing to bully... continuing to bully the Chinese airborne early warning, which is again going to hinder their ability to see this next wave of missiles too. Because these guys I got working right in that I believe their radar is on. And boop. Okay, so they are seeing them, kind of. Well, they were seeing them. I think the helicopter spotted them as it was ascending, and it got taken down. So they see they're on the way. They can roughly estimate when they'll show up in range, and you can see now they are showing up in range. But yeah, this is a difference having air cover makes, because look at how close they show up now. And I don't think... We can pop over to the other side for a second. Okay, these are the long-range anti-ship missiles, but even so... Here's where the Tomahawks are showing up. At about... maybe 25 miles out. And these long-range anti-ship missiles were showing up at maybe 15 miles out. Oh, there's a hit on the carrier. So it really shows you how vital an AWACS is for any sort of maritime operation. Just because it lets you see the shit coming and gives you time to react to them, as opposed to being like, oh shit, it's 20 miles away. You have maybe two shots to make them count. Boop. And there goes, I believe, their last helicopter. So all these they can still see now, but... just because they're within close range, but... Oh, nope, there's still a crowd coming in that they can't see. Oh. Yeah, the Shandong just doesn't take a lot of damage for some reason. I'm curious why that is. If it actually has armor or whatnot, but... Ooh, they had bad data on that missile, because I thought it was over here. But it looks like it hit the carrier. So their sensors are messed up there. There we go. We got multiple hits on the aircraft carrier. And their task group is apparently they wanted to take out this destroyer. Okay, that's our... So that's now three destroyers destroyed, a cruiser and carrier damaged. And we'll just play out the rest of this. Now we can see, again, these guys are in close enough range that they're being spotted by the carrier and the cruiser. And they're out of missiles, as you can see. So a lot of warfare like this, I think, ultimately just comes down to a little bit of luck, but also just who has more missiles. And it's not going to look pretty for the carrier. Spoiler alert. Boop. 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 So you can see now she's down to... They are taking out some of the... the aircraft that are on the flight deck. Boop. Boop. This thing is just a ridiculous damage soak. My god. I suppose it might... Okay, there she is. You know what happened here? Is one of the Tomahawks took out her communication. So that's why she still exists. She's still alive. But we can't get any information from her from her comms route, which, especially in older versions of the game, could be lethal and cause friendly fire. Just because you wouldn't be able to... Okay, there she's sinking. All right, now they're... Oh, you can see how they re-attack automatically. All right, so there goes the cruiser. Oh, the supply ship's getting hit now, and her comms are out. Now she's sinking. And now you have, they're left with one destroyer. And there's more missiles inbound, so you can see how, just changing, granted the aircraft helped, but... The whole point was that the U.S. had the missiles and the capability to engage that mass of missiles that kind of damaged the carrier the first time. And you can see that changing that weapons release authorization really helped with that. Obviously, there were still times where I had to step in and manually order an ERAM release because for whatever reason, they stop after the first wave. But it... You can see how it makes such a huge difference from, and our counterattack, even just by having a cap up, because they would go over here and shoot down their helicopters, they were having trouble seeing, how many missiles were coming on the way where they were. So our counterattack was more successful. And as you can see, we've now sunk almost their entire carrier battle group. And if I were to continue this scenario, we would sink their battle group and these two smaller groups. And granted, we do have a somewhat reinforced fleet compared to current Navy carrier battle groups, at least as they currently operate today. But I think it's reasonable for, you know, being on the verge of war as this scenario is intended. It's because we have, what, 5 destroyers and a cruiser. Plus the carrier, so... And the Chinese fleet is actually... was pretty similar in size. We can look at the, your losses and expenditures. I mean, they had 3... I think... Yeah, 4 destroyers and a cruiser. And the carrier and supply ship. So they're only short, like... 1 destroyer, technically, from what we have fielded. And they make up for that by having the 2 groups here that, while they don't have the air defense capabilities, they do add more throw weight to their opening punch. So, I think I like where the scenario is heading. Where... Why are you... Oh, they're going... Okay, I see what they're doing. Wow. Like, when I authorize, you know, engage... contacts, I didn't think they'd be going that far. Yeesh. But in any case, I think we're on the right track. There's obviously a lot of little changes to make. I might do a cleanup episode where I kind of just go over, you know, don't add anything new, like don't add new missions or whatever, but I just go over what's already there and kind of, you know, make everything work so that way when I hit the play button, we at least get, you know, this battle playing out in the air battle as it currently exists playing out. So that might be something I do next time. I guess we'll find out. But with that, thank you all for watching and stay tuned for next time and stay safe out there. We'll see you then.